Well, Stefan Dennis has starred as the villainous Paul Robertson since the very first episode of Neighbours 36 years ago.
Yeah, he's had some crazy moments on Ramsay Street. He's been shot, he's had an evil twin, and who could forget the moment Harold strangled him?
Yeah, I'm proud of you, Cam. You're doing well down there. I would love to have you come for a visit. Longer, if you're lying. What do you say? Oh, it was great, great. Best Christmas since you were kids. Right, Heronsbury is starting to feel like home again. Yeah. Yeah, well, listen, I better let you get back to your mum. Yeah. I love you, son.
The mild-mannered Harold did that. Paul survived yet again, and Stefan Dennis joins us now from the set of Neighbours. It's good to see you.
Good morning, guys. How are you? Feeling a little constricted there, I
think. Yeah. You have been through the ringer on this show. Paul has been shot, pushed off a mezzanine, strangled by Harold. Is Paul Robertson, in fact, immortal?
I think the short answer to that is obviously yes. I think what happened was they actually... They wanted to cast Paul Robinson. They ended up casting Count Dracula because it doesn't matter what they've done. You've just mentioned three. I think there's about another two dozen incidences that should have caused the death of Paul Robinson, the demise, but it hasn't. So, yeah, it's just going to keep going on.
Yeah.
This is what happens if you drop a 16-ton weight on him, eh?
Everyone would love to play the villain. What has been your favourite storyline over the years?
Oh, Tristan, that's got to be the silliest question in the world. I've been doing this for 36 years. By the way, can I just say, 36 years on Thursday, 2 days' time. 2 days? Yeah, 2 days' time. We are... Sorry, I can't remember anything. It's our 36th birthday.
Yay!
For on air. Because it was... I've actually done the 36th birthday because we started filming in the January, but we went on air in March.
Honestly...
1985.
Oh, it's such an institution. We love Neighbours. And we'll just... Sort of talking as well, because Tristan, obviously growing up in Ireland, you know, you guys were part of the family, watching you all the time, and, you know, do you get that weird kind of scenario where you're running into people on the street and they actually think that you're the bad guy, that you are Paul Robinson, and they really start kind of giving it to you?
I don't think that. Just before you answer.
It's actually been really weird because I always thought that. I used to hear horror stories from actor friends of mine who had played baddies for, you know, a short space of time. And I remember one guy and he said he was actually king hit in a bar by somebody who disagreed with what he'd done to one of the girls on the show, like, you know, dropped his girlfriend or something. And I used to live in fear of being happening to me from strange fans. And it's always been the opposite. I always get... Paul Legend, or, you know, things like that.
Keep
I think
your
it should be Legend,
close.
Actually,
that's
not Legend. Yeah, but it's really weird that people sort of, it's that old scenario of the villain that they love to hate. And because of that, yeah, I've actually had very nice encounters with people rather than the opposite.
Yeah, it just blows my mind getting to speak to everyone.
They do get... Sorry, I was just going to say that I have had situations where people have been afraid of me, though. There was one time, I was actually saying this the other day, I remember a long time ago, I went to go and buy bread and milk for breakfast one time. This is over in London at the height of the hysteria of Neighbours. And the woman was behind the counter was cowering back, and I was going, are you all right? Are you OK? And she said, oh, no, just take it. She said, I thought you were going to negotiate for the price. And I'm like, what?
It's such bizarre things. I don't know why.
He asked Dr. Carl for medical advice the last time he was on the show.
I don't know what it is. You always used to remind me of Jean-Claude Van Damme for some reason. I don't know why.
How's your roundhouse kick?
Okay. As in, hang on. What did you mean?
There's some very Jean-Claude Van Damme about you.
Or he's in... You're talking about, what is it, Universal Soldiers or something, where they couldn't be killed. That's me again.
But Neighbours runs in your blood, and your son Declan joined the cast last year with a guest role. He also plays a villain. What was it like to have your son on set?
Well, it's really weird because people have forgotten the other one as well. There's another family member who has been on the show who also played a villain, which was my darling wife, Gail. But, yeah, Declan was on... Because Gail played the character of Julie Quill, which was the undoing of Paul. She actually brought... Was one of the few people, a few characters that actually brought Paul Robinson down. But then she ended up paying dearly for it, and she's currently... That character's in jail. but it's good. I see her every night, though. Declan came on the show as the kind of the spoilt rich kid, I think he is, the character, and a bit of a bully, but he's sort of nasty but misguided, let's call him. But he loved it. He absolutely got into it, and like everything that Declan tackles, he's just a natural at whatever he does. And yeah, took to it like a duck to water.
That's oh, look fam. At you, very proud dad there. Now listen, Stefan Dennis, in real life, you are a very lovely bloke. You've actually been involved in Plan International, which is a charity organisation that's all about equality for girls. Tell us how you got involved and why it's important to you.
Well, I've always hated the idea of kids suffering, little kids suffering in any way, any sort of abuse. Or negligence, and I heard about Plan and the fact that you could sponsor kids overseas in poorer areas and war-torn areas and that. And so I like the idea of that. And what was really great is you actually get to go on the journey with the kid that you're sponsoring. It's not just like, oh, there you go, there's some money, throw some money at it and forget about it. You get updates from the kids all the time. They write you letters, you write them letters. And it's great because you actually see the results of what your money is actually doing. And it's even though I'm saying it's your money doing that, it's not about that. It's about, as you said, Sarah, it's about empowerment for kids in general, but particularly for girls. And I mean, a lot of people don't know, a lot of people do know, a lot of people don't know about the abuse that girls put up with, or in some cases don't put up with around the world. And as I say, particularly in the poorer areas and war-torn areas like Afghanistan, etc., where girls are at very, very young ages forced into marriages where, you know, the sexual abuse is phenomenal within these arranged marriages, forced marriages. And the kids, they've got no say in it at all. They're having children at you know, the ages of 13 and 14 when they should be having a childhood. So it's about empowering those girls. Plan isn't about just handouts and throwing money at the problem. Plan is about education and empowerment and letting kids understand their rights and letting kids understand that they have a place in this world, a real place in this world. And by giving, by allowing kids, and particularly the girls, who are the ones who, unfortunately, you know, a lot of these girls are living in areas where being a female is substandard. So to be able to empower those girls to think that they are above that is a wonderful thing, and to educate them on top of that so that they can then go on and create a better life for not just themselves but their community. And also, and it has a knock-on effect, because the more people that get educated in this world and can do great things for this world, it comes back. It's what goes around comes around. So we, in effect, you know, in the end, benefit from that as well. And I know Plan at the moment is trying, their campaign in the Australian government to try and create better funding for the Asia Pacific region, so that you. And it's funny because, you know, I work on a show called Neighbours, and people go, well, hang on, shouldn't we be sorting out the problems in our own backyard first? And yes, that is happening. And even though Plan has a program going on in the Northern Territory, their main area at the moment is in the Asia Pacific region, which, as I say, it's like, of course we have to help them, because
it's right on our doorstep.
I mean, you imagine if you're,
that's right, they're our neighbours.
Yeah, exactly. You know, if your neighbour was in trouble, you jump the fence and go and help them. Well, it's exactly the same thing. We're doing the same to our nation neighbours, if you like. So it's I could keep going on about Plan.
Yeah.
I mean, they're a wonderful organisation that really does think about the future, not just let's put a band-aid on it.
Yeah. Good on you. And you're obviously very passionate about it. Love thy neighbour, that's for sure. Tune into Neighbours tonight, or weeknights at 6:30 p.m. on 10 Peach. Stefan Dennis, it's always a pleasure. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks, guys. Good
Take
to see
care.
You.